左派一直对于投票这件事情耿耿于怀，总是要想尽各种办法来阻止正当的投票程序。在上周日，纽约市长将一项提案变成了法律。这个法律说的是，从明年开始，纽约市有80万的居民将有资格在市政选举中投票。80万的居民有资格？啥意思呀？能投票的不就是美国公民吗？绿卡都不行啊。这个法律说的是，不用你非得是公民，你不是公民，只要是居民就可以参与投票了。那什么样的人算是居民呢？只要你合法的在纽约市居住了30天，这样你就算是居民，就可以去投票了。也就是说，假设一个来纽约念书的外国留学生，他只要在纽约住了30天之后，就有资格可以参与投票了。他可以投票给纽约市长选举、纽约市议会选举、自治区主席选举、审计长选举和公共律师选举，但是不能在州或者联邦的选举中投票。做出这个决定的纽约市长并不是那个我们非常熟悉的不修边幅上电视吃汉堡的白思豪。这个白思豪现在已经下来了，不是纽约市长了。现任的纽约市长是今年1月1号新上任的 Eric Adams。 那么下面我们就来看一看针对这件事情他是怎么说的。
It's imperative that people who are in a local municipality have the right to decide who's going to govern them.
And what do you say to all the people who went through the process, the difficult process of becoming an American citizen?
I say to them, keep doing it. You know, membership has its privileges.
Membership has its privileges? What? 美国公民的 privilege 不就是投票权吗？那你说除了这个以外，永久居民跟公民还有什么区别呢？周一，共和党全国委员会就把纽约市告上了法庭。主席 Ronna McDaniel 在声明里面说，美国的选举就是应该由美国的公民来决定。如果民主党的人都可以在美国最大的城市公然的颠覆选举，那么他们可以在任何地方都这样做。共和党全国委员会为了维护选举的完整性，已经将纽约市起诉了。看到这儿呢，倒让我想起来去年的一件事儿，不知道大家还记不记得，在去年十月份的时候，我们有报道过一则新闻，拜登政府秘密的用飞机在半夜偷偷摸摸的从边境往纽约和佛罗里达州运送非法移民。我们一起来回顾一下。
Yep, go ahead, Peter.
Thank you, Jen. Why is the administration flying thousands of migrants from the border to Florida and New York in the middle of the night?
Well, I'm not sure that it's in the middle of the night, but let me tell you what's happening here.
4:29 a.m. Well, early in the morning.
Here we are talking about early flights, earlier than you might like to take a flight. It is our legal responsibility to safely care for unaccompanied children until they can be swiftly unified with a parent or a vetted sponsor. And that's something we take seriously. We have a right obligation to do that.
They arrive in the dead of night, as you said, and the curfew at that White Plains Airport is midnight, and these planes are flying in way after curfew. And then there are charter buses and a police escort waiting for them. And we just observed two flights from Westchester and one from into Westchester and one that left Jacksonville that came to White Plains last week. And of those, we saw about 100 migrants come off each plane. And we followed a couple of buses that went one to Long Island to drop some of these migrants off at about 1 a.m. at a sort of a group home, a former orphanage. Now they have a contract there, Mercy First, with the federal government to house migrant youth. There were several adults that, as far as I could see and my photographer could see, that came off these planes as well. The government is telling us they're all children, but it doesn't look like that to us. But regardless, it's all been done secretly. And if the federal government was not trying to hide what they were doing, they would show us who was on the plane and they would tell us where they were taking
right.
them. And they wouldn't be doing these flights in the dead of night.
It seems indisputable.
飞机上并不全都是小孩，也有成年人。而且刚才视频里面的照片，我们可以看到 那一大群等飞机的人身高都跟成年人差不多了呀，所以他们送的并不是那种年纪很小的小孩，而是一些即将成年的非法移民。 OK， 当时呢其实我并不是很明白为什么，因为在那条新闻之前我们也报道过，说拜登政府呢是用大巴、用飞机、用各种手段偷偷的把人往红州里面运。那这样的话呢其实很好理解，因为他们是要靠这些外来的人改变当地的人口比例，再加上选举投票不用看 ID 这件事儿，到了投票的时候，这些非法移民就会帮他们一个大忙，把红州慢慢的变紫，然后再变蓝，这个是很容易理解的。但是我那个时候就没搞明白，他们往红州运就算了，因为目的性是很明确的，那为什么要往纽约送人呢？我现在终于明白了，原来是有一个这样的法律会在一月份通过。左派为了达到目的可以一直装傻，这个是可以被理解的，因为他们不敢用正常的逻辑思维去触碰这些亟待解决的问题。但是对于很多人真的不是装傻，他们是真的认为左派说的非常有道理。比如说下面这个主持人，周日的时候乔治亚州的州务卿上了 CBS 电视台的 Face the Nation 节目，他和主持人就针对说为啥投票就必须得看 ID 这件事儿有了一些讨论。
We should have a constitutional amendment, a US constitutional amendment that only American citizens vote in our elections. And I think we should have also photo ID. We now have photo ID for all forms of voting in Georgia.
Only US citizens do currently vote in elections, but go on.
But we don't have a constitutional amendment. Now you see cities are trying to push non-citizen voting.I believe that only American citizens should be voting in our elections. That's supported by a wide variety, wide majority of all Americans, just like photo ID is supported by all demographic groups and a majority of both political parties. And that's what they've been using in Minnesota for over 11 years for their absentee balloting. So that's another, you know, solid common sense federal reform measure if they really want to get serious about election reform.
I assume there you're referring to the president and the vice president who will be traveling to your state in the coming days. They are doing so to campaign for two laws, the Freedom to Vote Act and the John Lewis Voting Rights Act.
Right.
The Freedom to Vote Act actually does promote a national standard for states that have an ID requirement for in-person voting. You could use a bank statement, a utility bill. I wonder, why do you think Republicans...
It does not have photo ID, and photo ID is the most secure way.Of using and making sure that you can identify who the voter is. And I think that's very important. And then they also want same day registration. And that's just, you know, very difficult for any election official to manage. And I think that undermines trust in elections.
为啥共和党人就一直找茬呢？投票为啥不能用银行账单呢？为啥不能用交水费电费的账单呢？那要是不然你就拿着试试，拿着银行账单跟水电费账单，你去买瓶酒买包烟看看能不能买。那么很显然这个主持人不知道现在在发生什么，他还以为只有公民才有权利投票吗？投票现在变得根本就没有任何规则了，这基本就是随便玩的状态，跟左派天天这么玩闹心上火，不如去以色列圣地旅旅游，不仅能够缓解缓解紧张压抑的心情，还能对圣经有更多的切身体会的认识。专精圣地旅游的迦南美地旅游公司这一次给我们大家带来一个好好的机会哦，我们一起去看看我们都会去哪里玩。
哎，伊森，你想不想去旅游啊？
想啊，听说最近以色列有效的控制疫情了，我超想要去耶路撒冷的。
哦，真的？好啊，那我们就要找一家行程最棒的旅游公司啊。
我知道，我推荐洛杉矶唯一专精圣地以色列耶路撒冷的迦南美地旅游。他们在三月份有一个圣地之旅，去以色列圣经中提到的重要景点
耶路撒冷的哭墙、耶稣祷告的克西马尼园，坐船游加利利湖，住在死海度假酒店，享受漂浮的乐趣。去圣地旅游回来之后，好多人都说，哇哦，我看圣经变成彩色立体的了。
而且迦南美地旅游公司这次的行程会带大家去埃及的开罗，去一趟摩西带领以色列出埃及所经过的马拉、以林和骑骆驼登上西奈山，参观世界上最古老的凯撒林修道院，
并且还去参观古埃及金字塔， 晚上乘坐豪华尼罗河游轮，一边看夜景，一边吃晚餐，还有精彩的歌舞表演，真的是物超所值啊！
大家需要详细资料，请和加南美地旅游的 Pamela 或者是 Wendy 联络，电话18777379937，
18777379937，
名额有限，赶快报名哦
！AI News 的观众朋友有优惠哦！
大家赶快抓紧时间报名了，名额有限，时间有限，报名截止日期就到这个月底。 AI News 的观众朋友还有特别额外的优惠哦。不知道大家都爱不爱看电影，有很多爱看电影的人都会关注一些颁奖典礼，像是奥斯卡呀、金球奖啊，都是每一年必不可少的节目。但是今年呢，金球奖居然已经过去了，就在礼拜天颁的奖，怎么都没听说过就已经结束了呢？因为今年金球奖没有现场的实况转播，没有明星，没有红毯，今年金球奖的颁奖典礼是在推特上举行的。那到底是一个什么形式呢？基本上就是隔一会儿就发一条推特出来，揭晓谁当选了哪一个奖项。这个金球奖在今年创造了一个历史，哪有颁奖典礼在社交媒体上举行的，连画面都没有。但是他们创造的历史不仅仅是这一个，还创造了另外一个，那就是变性人 MJ Rodriguez 凭借2021年的电视剧《姿势》获得了电视剧最佳女演员奖，成为了第一位获得金球奖的跨性别人士。
OK I gotta keep myself togetherOkay, so number one, y'all know I haven't been getting on live because I've been working real hard, but I gotta take this moment to say this because I couldn't really say all of this in a post. Like, I just posted and I'm definitely gonna be posting, but I have to say this. Number one, thank you, Golden Globes. This is for the LGBTQAI, Black, Latina, Asian, the many multi beautiful,colors of the rainbow around the freaking world. This is not just for me. This is for y'all. This is the door that opens for y'all. Not me, for y'all. There are going to be so many young individuals, young, talented, thriving individuals that are going to be able to trail in and storm in through the door. This is for y'all.
这整件事到底是什么呢？就是一个男的获得了金球奖的最佳女演员奖。女子的体育运动已经被男人侵略了，他们一群男的跑去跟女的比举重、比游泳。美国的第一位女性四星海军上将也是个男的，现在他们又跑到了电影行业里面，不去跟男演员竞争，一个男人跑来抢女人的奖项，我都不知道这到底哪儿公平了。他拿了这个奖怎么能够代表是有色人种的胜利呢？说是 LGBTQ 的胜利我是很同意了，因为他们接下来可以继续派出更多的男人侵略更多的女子项目。左派不是天天嘴上都在喊公平吗？他们做的事情真的公平吗？女人有自己的领域的奖项可以拿，他们全部把所有的女子奖项都变成男人的。左派每一天都在更加强有力的证明，女人就是比不过男人，男人就是比女人强，甚至做女人都比女人做得还要好。那对他们来说，妇女是二等公民，比赛让男人赢就好了。如果你要是敢说出事实来，你的言论就会被管制，你就不能说这个人他就不是女的，他就是个男的，小心你被封杀。Daily Wire 的主持人 Matt Walsh 因为发了一条推特之后被推特就禁言了。有史以来最伟大的赢得电视节目冠军的女性是一个男的，顶尖的女子大学游泳运动员是一个男的，公共卫生服务部的第一位女性四星上将是男的，男人在女子的高中田径赛和女子综合格斗赛中都占据了主导地位，父权制最终获胜。就是这样的一条推特，说男人是男人，男人不应该进入到女人的比赛当中，就因为这样他被禁言了。
I have to mention because I just found out 5 minutes ago、right before we went on the air that I just got suspended on Twitter because I pointed out that biological males are men And this to me, you know, is all part of the game here, that this is what leftism is. And if you criticize it, then they're going to shut you down because they realize that it's not like they can engage intellectually. It's not like they can defend intellectually anything that you, any of the examples that you just played. So this is the only option they have.
只要说了实话就会得到惩罚，即使每个人都知道男人就是男人，女人就是女人。这些赢得了女子比赛冠军的男人们，如果某天到了医院里面，医生还是会用处理男人的方式给他们做医疗决定。医疗处理方式不会因为他们大脑中的想法而改变，因为事实不是感觉，感觉也不是事实。如果你看了这些新闻，对这个世界感觉到有一点失望，对发生的事情都感觉有点无奈，那就赶快来一杯正义的味道吧。不管你是喝茶还是喝咖啡，哪怕你就是喝水，味道也会变得不一样。嗯，怎么多了一股正义的味呢？只要购买了12门徒及以上的会员，或者是通过邮寄支票和现金还有汇款转账来帮助我们的朋友们，千万不要害羞，也不要不好意思，我们真的非常非常感谢大家可以这样帮助我们，感觉到有大家的支持真的无以为报，所以我们呢就做了这样一个杯子来送给大家。欢迎发电子邮件到我们的邮箱 contactus.annews@gmail.com， 同时附上会员或者是付款截图就可以来领取啦。如果要是还想要买一些送给朋友的话，也可以点击信息栏中的链接单独购买哦。那么非常感谢大家，以上就是我们今天全部的内容了，我们下次再见。
大家好，我是大 LA 神奇快讯主播 Danny， 以下为大家播报一则社区活动消息。
有位英国人曾说，假使我有千磅硬币，中国可以全数支取，假使我有千条性命，绝不留下一条不给中国。而他的第五代子孙继续效法这样的精神，你会觉得感动、震惊，还是觉得他们是傻子？你渴望一个全新的开始吗？邀请您一起来听听这位说着流利中文的英国人他怎么说。2022年1月22日星期六，美东时间下午7:30，美西时间下午4:30，线上直播，由中华福音神学院院长戴季宗牧师带您了解如何拥有崭新的生活和生命。详情请洽北美好消息电视台 909-594-5599。